Mike Papantonio, unpack it for us.
Well, the difficulty the president's in right now is that he's doing what he has to do. This is evil incarnate. I mean, this has got to be stopped. But the interesting thing as you watch this discussion is on one side you have the very people who helped create all this. You know the story about how American arms and American involvement and all the way back to Afghanistan actually resulted in ISIS. We created ISIS when George Bush decided we need to go in and bomb Iraq for reasons that were wholly, completely made up. We helped create ISIS. So now you have a president that has to deal with ISIS. He has to deal with all this awful creation that he had nothing to do with, absolutely nothing to do with, as far as creating ISIS. And once you understand that, he's now left with the idea. The first thing he's going to do is criticize today. We got to put 350 more troops on the ground in Iraq. Well, he has to do that because it also has to do with ISIS. But the point is this, you know, what's so ugly about the talk shows, Ed, is they'll have some talking head about let's go bomb ISIS, let's go bomb ISIS, ISIS is evil, which they are. You've got to take ISIS out. Everybody would agree with that. But nobody asked the damn question, where did they come from? Nobody asked these characters that are critical of Obama and how he's handling ISIS, why did you let this happen? Why did you let that megalomaniac, Dick Cheney, put all of this into play to begin with? That's what we're not asking. That's what the media is not talking about. This didn't happen in an isolated kind of world, Ed. This came out of it came out of Ronald Reagan's involvement in Afghanistan, Dick Cheney's involvement with trying to bomb Iran, Iraq, Syria, you name it. Out of there came such dysfunction that you created an Islamic state that ultimately what we're going to look at is the people that live there are going to say, well, this is the only strength we have. This is going to build Islam back. This is going to be the new Islamist world. We built that world, Ed. And to have this president criticized by the very people who are responsible is agonizing to me, especially when you watch the Sunday talk shows and nobody has enough damn sense to ask, where did ISIS come from? And what did America have to do with inventing ISIS?
You know, I think right now the American people and we as a country are much more circumspect, much more cautious as a people because of the horrific mistake that was made when we invaded Iraq. And we're not on to sell jobs anymore as a country. And I think this president is well aware of that. And this isn't an answer that he's going to be able to come up with or a committee that's going to recommend and he's going to act on it quickly. This is going to be a long-term strategy that has to be well thought out and not the sacrifice that has been made in the past by the United States, because we just don't view this as our fight in many respects. To protect our homeland is the focal point. And is the focus of this administration, but also of the people. And there's always going to be these chatterboxes like John McCain, like Lindsey Graham. It's the same players
Wolfowitz.
Over and over
again.
Hell, now you got the right-wingers rolling out this Robertson dude, this Duck Dynasty guy. He is the Republican Party. He is the response. We're going to do a story on that tonight on the end show. This is where they are.
This is the brand, isn't it?
But it really is.
Ed, as you watch the story develop, ask yourself why nobody on no. Why is there no the problem is journalists don't understand this concept of who invented ISIS. Where did they come from? We don't talk about it because journalists don't take the time. And you can map it out. You can diagram it. You can say, why are they here? And then once you understand that, you really become angry when you understand that the people who are critical of Obama right now invented the damn thing.